right, let's see if it works this time. Oh man, the problems of living out in the country. Living out in the country. Hang on, guys. Let's do this. Let's see. The stream output. Oh man, gotta love my internet. My internet sucks so bad. Where was he? Oh yeah. Love guns. Plus the politics out of the whole deal. Alright, let's see if we can call this bad boy in here. If we can, we'll get a bow kill. Let's see. Let's see what happens. I used to do run and gun stuff on here, but the game has changed so much. I think we'll just take advantage of what's going on right now. Oh, hang on, guys. I don't know what the heck is going on with my internet. It decides it wants to be a piece of crap. Got to love Total, hey? I will say, though, having two monitors nowadays makes things a lot easier. But let's chat. What do you guys got? Anything for me? Tell you a little background. I used to travel full time as a musician. Did I make a lot of money? No. Did I have fun doing it? Oh yeah, it was my living forever. Do I love people? Yes. Do I know how to read people? Oh yeah, you bet. Oh man, it's the dough right there. Too, but I'm thinking about it. Nope. Okay. But yeah, no, I love people. I don't have to deal with people. But at the same time, now I work retail and I see so many personalities go through that store. Oh, man. I don't know about people. Times are weird. Times are different. It's a crazy world out there. But when someone goes out of their way to hoard and collect everything, I don't see no need in that. You know, you're making the world a worse place than what it is. When you do something like that. When you think of yourself versus others. And not to be a churchy person. This is coming from someone who does not spend a whole lot of time in church. But a person that is wise and knows what they're talking about. I believe it said in to the Bible is thou shalt not judge and thou shalt not hoard, or excuse me, thou should take care of thy brother. That was a joke on the hoard. And people are people. And some of those people are so-called very church-worthy people. Where I'm getting at with this whole deal is there is a lot of people that don't care about other people. Be like, oh, Brother Joe there in church. Trust me, Brother Joe probably doesn't give two shits about you. I'm not trying to make a huge statement here, but it's a freaking truth. And don't get me wrong, you guys are like, oh, you atheist, blah, blah, blah. I am not an atheist by any means. Not even close to an atheist. Yes, I believe in God, and I believe in a bunch of other stuff. But I have been to a lot of churches. And I'm going to tell you straight up, I am old enough to tell you this. The most judge-worthy people in the whole planet Earth are people in churches. And I did learn a long time ago is God and Jesus did not want a place for you to worship them. They wanted you to worship them in your household. Which times have changed and Bibles have changed over the years and centuries. That it is what it is now, but still though, I just don't understand. People are people. They are not perfect. They do what they do. Whoa, that's new. And it is what it is. But let's get to this. Let's get this right here. Cause I want this bear. No! Gosh dang it. I screwed up, man. I don't know how I screwed up. They caught my wind a little bit at a time. Oh, it's a good game. Well, anyways, not to get all religious. I'm just creating conversation. Even though no one's watching the stream. But, because I haven't been on for a while. And I can't stream all the time. I'm one of those people that is a person. I have a life. And I do believe not being online all the time versus Uncle Sam finding out where I am. And that's just how I am. But I do appreciate the people who watch my stream and follow my stream and all that stuff. And I'd love to stream more. Don't get me wrong, I'd love to stream more. And if you guys had comments, concerns, my stuff, my email and all that stuff is on there for this gaming channel. You guys, certain things you want to watch, certain things you want to talk about, chime in and I'll try my best. I am trying to get an actual better streaming schedule. It is so hard for my streaming schedule. I am a person with many trades, and I'm busy all the time. But I love gaming. I love playing games like this. And I'd love to hear what you have on streaming schedules. Like what works best for you, what sounds best for you. And I keep whistling. My character keeps whistling because I pressed the wrong freaking buttons. But anyways, let me know. Let me know. We have conversations. We can chat. We can do whatever you want. I prefer chat. Get a bunch of people on here. We debate. We chat. Anything but politics. Politics is a dirty word. Very dirty word. Dang it. I'm not used to my settings. Oh man, the wind's bad on me. The wind's bad on me. Let's hose myself down. I'm glad to see that they fixed that, though. Well, anyways, let's chat. Let's have a good time. I know there's a lot of people that play these games, but let's have one-on-one chat. Like, hey, how's your folks? How's your life? How's it going? What do you not like? What do you not like? I mean, yeah, don't get me wrong. We can talk about the game. We can talk about whatever you want. I don't care. This channel's free, open. This is a free spirit channel. And I don't care what Twitch says. I don't care if Twitch gives me money. I care about you. That's what I care about. There was a guy just saying that so you can get your money. No, trust me. I don't care about the money. I just donated a whole freaking massive game system to some kid because he can't afford anything. The kid got 5 Xboxes. I gave him 5 Xboxes. What's one kid gonna do with 5? He's like, why'd you give me 5 Xboxes? Because I wanted to. But when the kid called me and asked me about it, fame is very poor. And I was like, yeah. I said, I tell you what, I'll make you a deal. I'll give you an Xbox One and a 360 for $100. He said, okay, deal. He gave me $100. I brought all those. I brought 5 360s over and 1 Xbox One. They all work, by the way. And he hands me the $100 and I hand it back to him. I said, Merry Christmas. And I walked off. It is not Christmas, people. It is not Christmas by far, but the thing of it is, though, kindness, and the thing of it is, though, I have been there. I have been there as a kid, poor, and nothing to my name, barely affording shoes, And he accepted my $100 because that's the world. He accepted my $100 and he was going to give me $100 for all that stuff. Even though it was worth way more than that to him. But you know what else is worth more than that $100 to him? Kindness. Kindness that I gave to him that was granted to me through hard work and all this other stuff. That's what I gave back to him. So he learned a lesson. And he was prepared to work for it. And he did. He worked for it. He was shocked. Only said $100. But at the same time, when it came down to paying the Pied Piper, I returned it. Blew his mind. So, that kindness, and I told him, what I did was kindness. What I expect you to do is kindness right back to the same person. Now, I'm telling you guys this story because the same kid asked this person, hey, can I wash your car for $5? The old man said yes. He washed the old man's car. The old man proceeded to pay him. He turned down the old... Like, this is recent, people. This is recent. I'm telling you a story. This is actually, after I gave him this deal and I told him this thing. He washed his old man's car. This is how this kid makes his money. Washes his old man's car. Old man goes to give him $5. This is just recent. I was told by his parents. He told this old man, Merry Christmas. The old man said, no, son, here, you earned the $5. You washed my car. He said, no, sir. I know I told you $5, but I expect you to return the favor of kindness. And it is free of charge. And he did that all day. We're talking 1,300 cars this kid washed. We're talking just $100. You take 1,300 cars, $5 a piece, that's way more than $100. But this kid did what I said. Returned the kindness. He did that all day. And to him, he felt like he was right. And to me, I felt like I was proud. And you'll ask me, Why do I feel proud? Because the reason why I felt proud is that kid could have been greedy. That kid could have made quite a bit of money there. But out of all the days he's worked there, he's never made that much. If they tip. That's the thing is, the kid's a set rate fee. If someone tips, it's $5. But times are hard, so it's kind of iffy. So I'm just going off of a judgmental basis here, or a rough estimate. But let's say if they would have tipped you $5. Then yeah, you would have made a lot of money. Plus, what you did. But, also, this kid takes his time to look after his little sister, two little sisters, and a little brother. He's a good kid. But I respect the fact is, there's hope. Because there's a lot of kids nowadays, and I deal with a lot of kids, where there's no hope. And I wonder, I can't teach these kids nothing. And the reason being is because their parents don't teach them nothing. It's parents and respect. There's no more respect anymore. Man, that's way off. That was a waste of rounds. But there's no more respect anymore. Times are crazy. And a lot of times, I mean, I like playing for you guys and playing these games. But there's a lot of times, like, I don't need these games. Like, these games are my getaway, but at the same time, I like nature. Kind of like this game. But I don't need to play this game to feel free. I have went a whole day without my phone, and it does not bother me. And that's the problem with society, is society cannot do without their phone. I think we need to do a little bit more nature than we do technology. But at the same time, I do appreciate everybody watching Honeybun Gaming and stuff like that. But I haven't had a chance to stream until now. And I'm rambling on myself because there's no one on my stream. There's no viewers. So I'm going to talk freely. But people need to enjoy nature more than being on technology. If you come back and you watch the stream, and I appreciate you watching the stream, but if you do and you hear this part, go one whole day without looking at your phone. That's what I want you to do. And because of that, I'm going to leave it at this. And this game's amazing. But I'm going to leave it at you looking at your phone. That's where I'm going to leave it. I hope you guys have a good time. If there's something you didn't like, let me know. Comment, complain. I appreciate all comments and complaints. Y'all have a good one. Hey, I got a confession. Been losing all momentum. Just because it's easy. But that don't make it better. I wanna dig my hands deep down in the dirt. Take a walk along the street if I'm feeling deserted. We'll be right back.
see a locker and rescue say, boy, just don't bother. I know this all just makes me sound ancient, but sons and daughters, that shit was amazing. Can we take it back to 95 before we had this drama in our lives? Just staring at the screen every day and night. I miss the rush of living in real life. Go get your DeLorean. Go get your DeLorean.